The tense cross-strait situation was exacerbated by U.S. House of Representatives Speaker Nancy Pelosi's visit to Taiwan in August, and China blockaded Taiwan as a response. Scholars say this year has been the grimmest year for cross-strait relations since martial law was lifted.
The cross-strait situation remains tense, and there are no channels for communication between the two sides. The situation was exacerbated by U.S. House of Representatives Speaker Nancy Pelosi's visit to Taiwan in August, with China blockading Taiwan in response. Mainland Affairs Minister Chou Tai-sen previously expressed his hope the relationship would thaw as soon as possible. However, scholars said this year has been the grimmest year for cross-strait relations since martial law was lifted. China has begun erasing the imaginary Taiwan Strait median line. Scholars said that what Taiwan has jurisdiction over has withered, resulting in a national security crisis. Taiwan is also facing a diplomatic crisis with a mere 14 diplomatic allies left. The government is trying to participate in regional multilateral trade organizations, but scholars say its policy has clearly failed. For example, Taiwan was eager to join the Comprehensive and Progressive Agreement for Trans-Pacific Partnership to promote U.S.-Taiwan bilateral trade, but it lagged behind China in applying to join, leading people to say the government misjudged the situation. Scholars said the competition between China and the U.S. will persist, and Taiwan is at the forefront of this strategic confrontation and should avoid picking a side. The length of the compulsory military service period has been reinstated to 1 year, and the government said it will start communicating with the public next year on this issue. KMT legislators said Taiwan is moving towards full recruitment and full conscription, which are tantamount to a substantial military expansion. Legislators further asked exactly how many troops Taiwan needs and said the government needs to provide a clear explanation of its overall national defense strategy and objectives.